What we're about to play for you is a piece called Adventures on Earth. This is essentially, if you've ever seen E.T., who has seen E.T. in here, I hope it's good, the majority of us, excellent. So in E.T., the last about 10 minutes of the movie, which is a bicycle chase scene, and when E.T. goes back home, John Williams wrote this piece, basically Adventures on Earth. It wasn't called that, but that suite of music was created for the movie. Well, in recent years, it's about maybe mid-2005, 2006, Cow Letter, who's a music publishing company, makes a lot of music that we play. They decided to take a lot of John Williams' music and create a whole catalog just of his stuff. And they kept it true to the original, so minus scripts. They took an arranger and said, here is the orchestral score that the London Symphony or the Los Angeles Philharmonic play on the soundstage for the recording of the movie. Why don't you make it playable for a band? And so this arranger, Paul Lavender, took this piece, took out the strings, put all the string parts into the band somewhere, and created this piece. So in essence, it is supposed to sound exactly like the movie minus the string section. So it will have slightly different qualities of sound to it because there are no strings, but the notes you are about to hear are the exact same ones that the professional musicians played on stage when they recorded this for the movie. So we're taking it one step further. Not only are we playing this piece, but we're also timing it up with the movie, much like what Mr. Raynor did with Jackson, only instead of just audio, now there's video going with it. So I'll have headphones on, and you'll be able to watch the last 10 minutes of E.T. up on the screen. Of course, there will be no speaking. You won't hear the text. But most of that part of the movie is just music and action shots anyway. And that was kind of a big deal back when that came out in the 80s. It was one of the first times that a film director had said, hey, I'm going to give the composer of the music 10 minutes to just create music. There's going to be no speaking. We're just going to have music. And that really changed the